So I'm going to talk today about getting the most from Google Play. My name is Ellie Powers. I'm a product manager on the Google Play team. And I work on apps. Many of you are here building apps, but why, right? Why are we doing this? Well, for some of us, it's because we have a particular idea that we're really passionate about and we want to get out into the world. For some of us, it's because we have an idea for an exciting new business that doesn't exist yet. And the sort of world that we're talking about is this multi-device, multi-billion person world that's grown over the past decade or so. And we're also going to talk about how Google, specifically Google Play, is uniquely positioned to help you get your idea and your business out into the world and as successful as possible. So first, a little bit about me. I love to travel. I've been to countries all over the world, and my favorite thing when I travel is to go to a place that's going to make me feel a little bit out of my element. The other reason I love to travel is they tell me that it's supposed to be a really good idea to get away from your work from time to time. But unfortunately, when you work on mobile apps, this is getting really hard to do, actually. So about a year ago, I went on a trip to Thailand and Cambodia. And when I was on the subways in Thailand thinking, yeah, I'll get away from my work, I'm seeing ads for Android games. And then I go to the markets in Cambodia, and I see Android devices for sale. And it's really a nice reminder that the work that we're doing here to build this mobile ecosystem together is really reaching people all over the world. And today, here we are in Moscone Center, and we're seeing that the wave of Android is now going in both directions. Not only are our users everywhere, but there are developers all over the globe. Just actually across here on the floor here, we have a developer called Rayark, also from Southeast Asia, and they've made a beautiful immersive game experience, and if you haven't seen it yet, I definitely recommend that you go and check it out afterwards. So these are the sorts of strong mobile ecosystems that we're building all around the world, and they're tied together through Google Play. So how did Google get involved in this whole mobile apps thing? Let's go a little bit further back into Google's history. So my first experience with Google was, you know, this box, and you could just type stuff into the box, and, you know, it would just find things for you. It was kind of magic. And this was the first opportunity that a lot of us had to see just how big the world was and that seemingly faraway ideas and places were now becoming within reach. And so this was what Google started out with, connecting people with the information and the products that they were interested in. So what happened next? Well, on April 1st, 2004, Gmail launched. In 2005, YouTube joined Google. And then with Maps and other key launches, Google became known for customer-centric internet experiences and really, really enormous scale. I mean, you may have remembered what a big deal it was, you know, over 10 years ago when you finally got a whole gigabyte for your online email, where people were offering just a fraction of that. And this meant that your information could be truly accessible from anywhere. And this was happening on the web. It was happening on desktop computers. Maybe you remember having a dial-up modem and that big upgrade moment to DSL, and this was cool and exciting. And let's fast forward to today. While Android had joined back in 2005, what's happened in those, you know, almost 10 years is that we've now moved on to the next chapter of the internet. We have billions of people connecting. Many of them are using Android as their first device. And what happens? What is the difference between your desktop computer and a website with your mobile device today? You're now in this kind of loop of constant interaction. You've replaced clicking and typing with, you know, touch screens, voice controls, and sensors. And Google's still doing what Google has always done best, which is connecting people with the information and products that they find most interesting. What this means here is now connecting people with the apps that they love on a range of devices. So what we're going to do today is talk about what this means to developers, like all of us. So again, why do we develop? Why do we build apps? It's to get our ideas and businesses out into the world. And an app is definitely the best way to do that in this day and age. So what we're going to talk about today is how your app can reach the right users at the right time, and the approach that you'll take is going to depend on what stage your app is in. So first, I want to talk to those of you who are just getting started. Maybe you've just built an app or you have an idea for one. You don't have any users yet, so that'll be your first challenge. So before you publish your app, you probably want to understand this ecosystem that you're joining, and that's Google Play. So what is Play? Play is an ecosystem of apps, developers, and the store. We have, you know, the 1 billion devices that were discussed before and the people who use them. Well over 1 million apps are in the store. And behind the scenes, we have massively scaled cloud computing services that can help to do everything that we're going to talk about next. What I think about what Google Play really is at its core is a matchmaker. If I'm a user, it's going to try to match me with the sort of app that I'm going to want. Maybe I'm looking for that app, or maybe I don't even know I'm looking, and it's just helping me discover something new about what my device can do. And then on the other side, if I have an app, it's going to match me with the sort of users who are going to be interested in my app. So let's start out with something new, something that's coming soon, something that we're incredibly excited about. So earlier in the keynote, you heard the discussion about material design. And on Play, we're really trying to take this beautiful interactive layout to heart. Now, when you launch a new app and you put it up on the Play Store, you really want to make a great first impression. So we've decided to make the store listing on Google Play even more appealing. And by the way, this is just a general concept. It's not totally done. But we wanted to share it with you early so that you can understand the context in which your app will be available. So at the top, you can see this beautiful feature graphic. And at the bottom, you can see a quick text summary where you can explain to users exactly what your app will do for them. So you might want to go into the developer console today and make sure that you actually have this graphic and text available so that when we roll this out, your app will be ready. And in the middle here, you're going to see the reasons why the user may want to install the app. So for example, a great reason to install the app is it's got a high star rating, so we call that out really clearly. Or maybe it's got a lot of downloads. Or maybe it's because, you know, your friend has installed it and given it a high rating. So this is going to be rolling out soon, and we hope that it'll help you make your apps give a better first impression. Okay. When I go out in the world and actually talk to Android users, I like to ask them how they find about their favorite apps. The number one reason I hear again and again is, well, I found this app because my friend told me about it. Perfectly natural. And that's why on Google Play, we're trying to reflect the same behavior. Whenever we see that your friend has rated or plused one an app, we tell you about it. And we also show you why we make each interaction. We don't just say install the app, we say you should install this app because. So what this does is it creates a ripple effect. If you find one user who installs your app and gives you a rating or plus one, it'll ripple out to affect all of their friends and build more momentum behind your app. You can also now follow top brands like Wired or The New Yorker, or even celebrities. So we talked about Play being a matchmaker. How do we do this? We're using the full power of Google and the user's full profile to be able to target the right app to the right user at the right time. We've also created these targeted groups of apps based on user interests. So here, you can see racing games, and you can also see food and drink apps. And we don't necessarily show these groups to everybody, only to the people who we know have these interests. We also show personalized recommendations that are based on a whole variety of things we know about the user, including what their friends have recommended. And Play Games is something that's really helpful for those of you who are making game apps. Play game services are a great way to enhance your app, to make it more social and more fun. We launched it at last year at I/O, and we've heard that it's a great way to discover more games and also to engage with the games that you're already playing. So today at I/O, we announced some really exciting features, including the new user profile, which you can see here. It's showing which games you play and the achievements. For example, on the screenshot behind me, you can see how many experience points that this particular user has accumulated in different types of games. And then you can also create what are called quests inside your app. You can say, hey, user, why don't you go and accomplish this particular objective in a limited time? And then we'll also go and show those quests in the Play Games app to help recruit new users. So if a user is looking